I'm here tonight down on the night shift in the Bromford Tunnels. Birmingham's behind me, Delta Junction to the far end. I'm in tunnel number two now. Tunnel number one broke through in May and the TBM has been removed. There's a few more days worth of tunneling to go on in this TBM, so we're going to go and have a look at it. It's 5.8 kilometers in there, so we're waiting for the equipment to take us in there. So we're currently traveling in what's known as an MSV, a multi-purpose service vehicle. So these things, they take the segments in together with service pipes. We're at TBM 2 now. She's only a few more days to freight through. You can see the segments being delivered on the MSV. They're going to take those segments off and we'll be taking that MSV back out again in about another 15, 20 minutes. But we're now just in the TBM control room. As you can see here, bank of equipment to monitor. The pilot will guide the TBM. So everything's monitored from this cabin.
We're just here now in the ring building area. They've pulled the hydraulic rams back, putting the segment in, and it'll be put in position and then lofted to position. And then the next one repeats until you get the whole circle. You can see they use a radio controlled module to move the ring. The segment has multiple directions where it can adjust to get right. Guy with a spirit level at the top, making it nice and easy. When it's ready, they will then push these rams back out again, and that'll hold it in position. The whole tunnel is effectively one continuous operation, but there's a 12 minute gap where they don't excavate, they just build. So that's the first segment in position now. That's held in position by these massive rams, and they'll now bring in the next one and put that in position. These segments weigh about 7.5 tons each. This is what's known as a vacuum erector. It takes the pressure out and it's purely lifted by vacuum. It's got an emergency fail safe on it, so in the event the vacuum was lost, you wouldn't fall down. So there's no men touching this segment. The machine picks it up, the machine puts it in place. All the people are stood out the way, so they're nice and safe to work. It's a challenging place to work. They're down here 12 hours. They have a mess facility on the back of the tree. Toilets, they have their meals here. It's about a 45 minute journey in. When you get into the TBM, it's a very hot, humid environment, quite noisy. It's a tough gig to work here for 10 hours straight. This machine is the last of the Midland TBMs to break through. It'll break through shortly. All the other machines in the Midlands are completed. So the only remaining TBMs to drive after this will be the one from Old Oak Common into Euston, which will start next year. So we've completed to date about 85% of the bored tunnels in HS2. So imagine how difficult it is to do any maintenance on this machine. You can see how tight everything is, all the cables, all the hydraulic pipes. We're standing now just where what's known as the screw conveyor. And if you remember your physics, it's an Archimedes screw that takes the material from inside the cutter head over there, takes it through, the pressure decreases and it hops out the back into the slurry system. When we were in the ring building area, you could see some of the sealant that was sticking out. This is the sealant that they put in the back of the ring to stop water coming in. It's like a very, very sticky, environmentally friendly grease equipment. It's designed to be very, very sticky to stop water coming in. These are all automatic pumps that pump in so that there's no operator involved other than to change the barrels. So the area we're stood in now is where the services get extended that feed the TBM. So you'll have water pipes, you'll have compressed air lines, you'll have electric cables. As the TBM moves forward, these pipes are then added on to enable the TBM to continually mine. So much, much quieter now. We're probably 60, 70 meters back from the front of the machine. So the further you go that way, the warmer it gets, the more noisy it gets, the more humid it gets. Here's a much nicer environment to work in. Some of the pieces that we've seen over there, this is the screw conveyor. So you've got the cutter head there, the machine cuts the ground, comes up the screw conveyor, goes into the slurry system. The slurry takes it eventually through on pipes, and you can see the slurry pipes on the wall over here. You've got the segments get dropped off here. So we were watching the ring build area here, the erector arm picking up segments, building it. These segments were brought in with the MSV, so they'll be put into a cassette system where they get transferred into the face, picked up by the erector arm, and the guys then build it. So it's now 10 o'clock. We just finished the inspection of the TBM.
The night shift will carry on until 7 o'clock in the morning. These guys, they're doing a lot of work. It's a difficult, challenging place to work. We're going to go back to our beds. These guys have still got another few hours to go until lunchtime. And then 7 o'clock in the morning, the day shift come in and repeat. So the guys are doing about 10 to 12 rings per 24 hours. So that's about 20, 25 meters a day, effectively. So they do roughly six segments in the day shift, six at night shift, 24 hours a day, 5 days a week. So yeah, it's an amazing piece of civil engineering.